I'd like to thank all the churches who have taken this initiative. I think this is very welcome. So let us work together and embrace each other the way I've done. So please, I've given you all the blessings and enjoy your stay, Livingstone, and make sure that this message should just not just remain in Livingstone, let it also overlap in other countries. At this moment, I would like to officially flag off this program.
For the nation of Zambia.
So it's very good that you
the honorable minister was not able to make it, the government is present at this meeting. It is now my rare honor and privilege to declare Watchmen on the World Prayers Summit officially open.
I'm reminded of something in the scripture where God says, I have set watchmen on the walls of
Israel
who shall not keep peace, but they shall keep crying unto God till God establishes Zambia as a praise of other nations. So I implore the watchmen, watch.
they are going to pray for Africa,
America,
Asia, Europe,
the nation of USA.
We enter the Arabic nations right now.
The nation of Zimbabwe.
God, we present Namibia before you. The country of Zambia.
Father, we bring the nation of Israel before you.
To present Australia,
connecting the country of Botswana, King Eterno.
As I stand on the national altar,
yes.
Zambia, hear the voice of the Lord.
Yes.
The land of Zambia, hear the voice of the Lord.
Yes.
The waters of Zambia, hear the voice of the Lord.
Yes.
Any living preacher in this nation, hear the voice of the Lord.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
And so as watchmen in these last days, God is calling us to be snipers in the spiritual realm. That when we aim, when we pray for the souls, when we pray for our nation of Zambia, that people, chains will be broken, that the enemy has no power against us. It is enough is enough. We don't want to just be soldiers, and that's fine. We need soldiers. Everybody has a purpose, but we want to be snipers, hallelujah, in the spiritual realm. We want to be able to receive prophetically. We want to be able to see, Father God, what is it concerning Zambia that you want us to pray for? Let us see the attack before it comes so that we can actively stand firm upon his word and target the enemy. And let our prayers pierce the kingdom of darkness. Let our prayers pierce the kingdom of hell to set souls free. Hallelujah. Because God's desire is that Zambia become a praise, that all souls, he said, not just one soul. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. Hallelujah. But he is calling you, young adults here in Zambia, to stand up and be watchmen.
Isaiah 2:2, and this last day is the mountain of the Lord, hallelujah, shall be established in the top of all mountains, and shall be exalted above all hills. Hallelujah. So the mountain of the Lord is holy. The mountain of the Lord is the Lord's house of prayer. And the mountain of the Lord is the Lord's altar of prayer. There is a Zambia here that we can see. Hallelujah. Physical Zambia. But the new Zambia, it will take a prevailing. Hallelujah. It will take a blessing in the spirit. It will take the young people to arise, to come to the altar of the Lord, to pray with consistency, to pray with persistency, to pray in traveling, to give birth to the new Zambia. Hallelujah. The glorious Zambia. The Zambia that shall be holy. The Zambia that shall be before the throne of Jesus. That Zambia needs you and I to travel. Hallelujah.
You don't know. Someone say my word.
What is happening when you are clapping?
When you are clapping your head, your feet.
Something is happening. There is power in worship and prayer. If I had to learn how to worship, to learn how to praise.
Hallelujah.